Tchau. So we have Elizabeth Chop House. It's on Front Street here in Marquette. It's overlooking Little Harbor and the old Ordot on the far like exterior. The owners are Chef Tom Wallstrom and his wife Elizabeth. They bought the property in July 2007. It was an old bar, but it transformed into what it is now. Their ultimate goal in transforming it and creating it was to create a place where when diners came in, everything exceeded their expectations. And they're definitely known for a great service. That's a highlight. They have a dining room, a private dining room, that can hold up to 25 guests, and a back deck overlooking Little Harbor. And they use fresh flowers, clean white linen, the kind of things you would walk into a restaurant of that caliber and expect. And they have on the menu the finest cuts of prime beef, fresh seafood daily, freshly made gourmet desserts. The bar has cocktails, liquor, there's an extensive wine menu, and French pressed strawberry coffee as well.
All right, next we're going to be diving into the situation analysis and company overview. As far as what the steakhouse is appearing to be and trying to be, they are the premier steakhouse in the entire 906 area. Outside of the Marquette County, they are the most exclusive, most expensive, and most established steakhouse. They are very aware of their demographics and who they're targeting. Based on their prices, atmosphere, you know, the dim lighting, the white tablecloths that we talked about. With that though, they do hold a couple very prominent problem areas. The most extensive being their almost entirely inactive social media platforms. The photo on the right is one of their filet mignons, and it came on June 9th, 22. That's their most recent photo of any of their dishes from over 70 weeks ago now. With that, the owners have also kind of mixed in their personal accounts, or they treat their business account as their personal accounts, posting selfies of each other and their accomplishments rather than any photos of their business inside of the restaurant or any of the dishes. And then with that, they're very much in need of a rebrand or a refresher. Partial rebrand. They know what they're doing, but they need to update things. They need to hire a social media manager to clean up their aesthetic. Continuing with that, the analysis, just as far as the demographic variables, overall, their main target customer is one that is willing and able to spend the type of money that it takes to attend and have a meal at the Chop House. That indicates those that come indicate a higher income and education and employment. Geographically, again, we talked about how it's primarily people coming from the 906. But a good portion of them seasonally come because of events for celebrations, certain occasions. That can include graduation. There's a lot of kids graduating from MU or high school. And parents will come up and spend money on a meal there with them. Marquette also being a strong and the largest vacation town in the UP. Seasonally, they do very well in the summer. The same as their competitors around the area, Iron Bay, Blagnac, Bierling. As far as the psychographic variables, the majority of people coming to the restaurant have a strong reason to come to it. They're celebrating, there's an occasion. There aren't too many regular customers as Marquette is not a huge town, and there isn't an extensive line of people that have a obnoxious income that can spend the amount of money that it takes to dine here regularly. Behavioral, again, occasions are a big factor, but inexperienced versus experienced customers here is a big part of it. The menu is big, and experienced customers either like it or don't like it. Those that like it will return, and will be looking to try out things on the menu. As far as the inexperienced customers, though, that problem area of the social media, this, and they haven't refreshed it, haven't brought in new elements.
And then for the SWOT analysis, the main selling point of Elizabeth's Chop House is their fine dining experience. They have very high quality foods, and a variety of them ranging from steak, lamb chops, chicken, shrimp, lobster. And their service is also very good. Their owner and chef will go table to table to make sure everyone's enjoying everything and having a good time. They have very good reviews on Kayak, Yelp, Facebook. Everywhere is at least a 4.6. And then onto the weaknesses, their main weakness is their marketing. They do not market themselves very well. Their Instagram page hasn't made a post since July of last year. Their Facebook page is mostly just page, pictures of the owners celebrating anniversaries and whatnot. Their business hours aren't the longest. They operate from 4 to 9, Saturdays to Sunday. Could be a little longer. And their parking lot is small. Closest good parking is about a couple blocks away. For opportunities, they can market themselves better on social media by posting more on Instagram or Facebook. They can make their hours longer, try and get people in for lunch and stuff. They could also partner with local businesses, like say a local winery or farmers. And there's always the threat of a new competitor entering the market to take away customers. Then they have the existing competitors like Beerly, Landmark, Iron Bay. And then another threat is they can deal with seasonality. In the winters, a lot of people are indoors, not going out as much. Then in the summer, college students go home, so they can lose the customers from that.
And I'm going to talk now about the digital marketing plan. And for us at Elizabeth's Chop House, we found the two main things that we have to focus on to increase digital marketing presence is a website redesign and to focus on social media presence, as they have mentioned a bit so far in this presentation. So our first step is a website redesign. The brand identity and navigation currently on this website is a little jumbled. It's very clear in the design choices that they make what type of restaurant this is and what vibe, I guess you could say, they're trying to exude. But it's very clear that this website hasn't had any updating or redesign since 2011. And I say that because there is a function on the website called the blog function. And the last time they posted on that was 2011. So I would assume that that's the last time any work has been done on this website. The other issue that we want to fix with this website is the navigation. It's very difficult for customers to understand where they need to go to find information on this website. If you see here, this is a menu, and up there is also another menu. So not only are there multiple places to put the information, it's located not together like it should be. And on top of that, this reservations page comes up with every single tab that you click on, even if you're not in the reservations tab. That reservations option will be up no matter what. And that's a bit of a redundancy that's not really necessary in the web design. Some questions to consider with this web design and with the digital marketing objectives as a whole are: what types of customers are Elizabeth's Chop House aiming to attract? And we'll talk about that later in the target audience section. And how can Elizabeth's Chop House attract that type of customer? That type of customer, as Kaden mentioned, they know how much money they have to spend, they know why they want to spend it, and where they want to spend it. And the problem with the brand identity not matching online what Elizabeth's Chop House is trying to present, it creates a cognitive dissonance for that customer, and it can allow them to potentially even choose another restaurant if they feel that, if this website experience gives them that subpar feeling, that feeling may translate in the restaurant experience. And the second phase is, as we've mentioned before, social media presence. The Facebook and Instagram account that Chop House currently has. They have around 3,000 Facebook followers and just above 200 Instagram followers. It's 211 Instagram followers. The Instagram account is much more professionally set up. There are no posts from the owners celebrating their personal achievements or personal anniversaries or whatnot. But again, they are not boosting that Instagram page in any way. They don't have any form of paid search or paid advertisement in the social media realm. When you search Elizabeth's Chop House, the first thing that comes up is their website and then a couple of other links that are not related to Elizabeth's Chop House. Their Facebook and their Instagram does not come up right away. And again, consistency in posting is also something that we've mentioned and is really important when it comes to digital marketing. They haven't posted anything in a very, very long time. And I can imagine that before the last time they posted that, it was a long time before they posted anything previously. And with the brand identity that we talked about with the website design, that's also something that needs to translate over to the social media pages that you have as a business. And currently that is not happening with, as we've mentioned, especially in the Facebook page, with the business owners using it as a personal page, that brand identity is completely lost. Our target audience, again, is people with money to spend at this restaurant. This is a high profile, expensive dining experience, and people who come here are looking for that. Those are higher income individuals or business professionals in the area, people who are celebrating anniversaries or graduations, any form of celebration in the area. There are lots of opportunities for Elizabeth's Chop House to cater to that demographic, especially with their balcony seating and their extra larger room for guests. Again, the questions to consider with this are what types of customers is Elizabeth's Chop House aiming to attract? And I think that the owners themselves know what customers they'd like to attract. The problem is actually getting there in their digital presence. And the easiest way, I do believe, to do that would be to hire a social media manager to give them the guidance that they need, because I believe the owners are a little older, they're in their 50s or 60s. So they may not be just as privy to what it takes to market yourself digitally. So I believe that having a social media manager would help them in that instance. You guys have any questions?